Hashem imlach le'olam ba'el. Hashem elech, Hashem malach, Hashem imlach le'olam ba'el. Hashem elech, Hashem malach, Hashem imlach le'olam ba'el. Hashem elech, Hashem malach, Hashem imlach le'olam ba'el.
It's as though God was saying, I want the tree to come from the soil, and the tree will need the soil to live. I want the fish to come from the water, and the fish will need the water to live. And I want man to come from me, so that a man will need me to live. And anytime man gets confused that he does not need God, let him look in his backyard. And anytime he gets a PhD and he thinks he doesn't need God, let him take his beautiful goldfish out of the water. It doesn't matter how big the fish is in the sea. The fish can never get so big that the fish does not need the sea. You can be Bill Gates. You still need God. For the same reason, fish needs water. And for the same reason, the trees in your garden need the soil.
And Jesus wants to heal you. He wants to heal you emotionally, and he wants to churn them into scars. And the scars will be a testimony. They will still be there, but they're not going to hurt. There is a level of freedom that you're not going to get by just somebody praying for you. The truth is Jesus. As you continue to know Jesus, as you're going to continue to grow, you're going to grow.
I'm Nadia, I'm from Vancouver, Washington. Something inside with me was telling me, you need to be here. There's something out there for you. And so I had all this pain and scars, and I had this kind of depression. And when I came here, I wanted somebody to place their hands on me and pray for me. I wanted that upliftance. I wanted somebody to say something to me to give me courage. And when Vlad came up to me, like, I just knew that this is God, like, speaking to my heart. And he said that your scars will turn into stars, and that depression to let go of all of it and just give it to God's hands. And I had tears and I was crying, and just happiness and joy came to me in confirmation that God is doing his work in my life.
Будет время в твоей жизни, где твои взаимоотношения с Святым Духом станут крепкими. Не потому, что ты чувствуешь его, но потому, что ты его не чувствуешь. А ты погружаешься двумя ногами на Божье Слово. Ты будешь чувствовать плохо. Не говори плохо. Ты будешь чувствовать болезнь. Говори исцеление. Ты будешь чувствовать бедность. Говори, что Господь, Он пастырь мой. Ты будешь у гроба Лазаря, и слезы будут течь по твоим глазам. И будет внутри просто скорбь. Но открой свои уста и говори, что Он не мертвый, Он жив. И только тогда Он выйдет.
Меня зовут Валентина, я из Ванкувера. Когда умер муж, и мне позвонили по телефону, у меня внутри, я не знаю, как это на физиологическом уровне объяснить, у меня внутри что-то сжалось, как будто все внутренние органы сжались в одну пружину. И началась дикая боль в сердце. И с этой болью, с этим ощущением пружины внутри, я находилась до момента, пока не началась молитва брата Влада.
Скажите, пожалуйста, когда Владимир начал молиться за исцеление и попросил положить руку на больные места, что произошло в этот момент с вами?
У меня появилось какое-то чувство удушья. И вдруг что-то легко-легко мне стало. Я не знаю, как это объяснить. Мне стало легко. Эта тяжесть, эта боль внутри меня ушла. Боль в сердце появилась острая, и под лопаткой потом вдруг все ушло. Я не поверила самой себе. И слезы задушили меня, слезы закрыли мои глаза, и я не видела, что происходило вокруг меня.
Hello, can you please tell us your name and where you're from?
My name is Sasha, and I'm from Republic of Georgia.
Hello, Sasha. We welcome you today to this service. Would you please tell us what was the problem you were struggling with?
I've had right shoulder pain since I was 10 years old because my shoulder was not formed properly when I was born. I had mostly muscular pain, which was radiating into my back and into my neck.
What were the things that you could not do? Well, how did that affect your everyday life?
I was having trouble sleeping. Just the daily activities would create a lot of pain, and I couldn't do a lot of things that I enjoyed doing before.
Where were you in search for solution?
Well, number one, I went to the doctors. I've seen multiple doctors for this problem, and then they ended up having to do two surgeries.
Did those surgeries help you?
A little bit. It did relieve the intensity of pain, but the pain has never went away.
Okay. And so what God has done today through the prayer at this service for you?
During the prayer, I took it in faith that God would heal me and that He would take the pain away. And immediately, when I said the prayer, the pain has gone away, and then the muscle spasms released.